Hey guys, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. So for today's video, this is going to be my empties part 2. So I'm just going to share products that I've used up recently, beauty, makeup, all that stuff, and just give my opinion on it, if I recommend it, if I'll repurchase it, and yeah, so let's get started. So the first product I'm going to start with are these hair, skin, nail vitamins. I mentioned this last time because I used up my bottle last time and then I went and bought a new one and now I need another one. I didn't buy this yesterday on Walmart's website. It said that it was in stock and everything. I added it to my cart and then it said it was sold out. So I have to find these somewhere. Target is sold out. It's so hard to find these. So whenever I come across these again, I'm going to buy like 5 bottles of them so that I'm stocked up because clearly that's what I should have been doing. But I would definitely recommend these. I feel like they definitely help with your hair, skin, and nails. Like, my nails be growing at a rapid pace. I trim my hair constantly, so definitely recommend these. So I have 3 products that aren't technically empty, but I'm just gonna get rid of them because they're either old or I just don't like them. So first is this Profusion palette. It just didn't really work for me. I didn't really care too much for the colors. Like, this one just didn't, it's like my skin color, so it didn't really show up at all for a contour color. This one was okay. And then the highlighters, I feel like, were just very powdery. So I'm just gonna get rid of this because I tried to use it multiple times. Next thing is just this Kylie Matte Liquid Lipstick. This is the shade One Wish. I just don't really like the color. It's like kind of peachy. And I just don't think it looks good with my skin tone. So I'm never gonna use this either. I like Kylie's liquid lipsticks. I do think they're expensive and you can find like cheaper ones. So I wouldn't repurchase any of her stuff. That was part of like a holiday kit, I think, from last year. This Maybelline Baby Skin. I used to love this stuff when I was in like high school and college, but I realized like it doesn't do anything for me. I don't like the silicone-y texture and I have oily skin. I feel like it makes your skin look really smooth, but that's about it. So next I have this e.l.f. Matte Oil Control Lotion. I love this stuff. I already have a new one. Just so you guys don't think I'm joking, I have a brand new one that I opened. So yeah, I love using this before I use a primer. It just makes your skin look so nice and dry, but like not the dry type where you look crusty. Just if you have oily skin, you know what it looks like when you're dry. It looks so nice and, you know, not like a glazed donut. And I'll keep repurchasing this as long as they have it. Smashbox Photo Finish Primer. This primer is nice if you want like that silicone texture again. I feel like it does make your skin look really nice and smooth. This was actually a gift. It came in a little set. But I just wouldn't repurchase this because I don't want silicone texture. Actually, I have another one that's like a sample size that I'm using up. I used it today, which my skin looks nice, I think. It looks smooth. But I don't want that for like throughout the day because I'll be oily in a couple hours. Concealer from Maybelline. This is a Superstay Full Coverage Under Eye Concealer. This was nice. I wouldn't repurchase it. I feel like I have other concealers that are my favorite. I don't have any complaints about it. I just wouldn't repurchase it. It didn't really do anything too amazing. I feel like I have better concealers. I'm pretty sure I mentioned this in my last video because I just am obsessed with these brow pencils from L'Oreal, the brow stylist, definer. I stock up on these. I will admit, I buy these anytime I go like to Ulta or, you know, wherever. I don't feel that there's a need to be buying Anastasia products or anything like that when there are so many cheaper alternatives. If you like those products and you want to spend the money on them, girl, go ahead. Like, do what you want to do. There are 2 items, I think, from Ulta. So first is this eyeliner. This eyeliner, I wouldn't repurchase. I only used it on like my top line. And it had like a hard time even staying up there, so I can't even imagine how it would be on my waterline. I don't think it would last at all. Ulta Bold Ambition Mascara looks like this. This was part of like, I think maybe one of Ulta's bags that they give away or something. So I didn't pay for this. I got this for free somehow. I wouldn't purchase this. I feel like it did make your eyelashes long, but it was like spider lashes almost. So I would use this with another mascara just to make it long and like more fluffy versus all stuck together. So I'm gonna pass on repurchasing this. I have 2 of these Milk Makeup mascaras. These were just like the sample size that I got for free one time. And I actually used up both of them. I like this mascara, but I don't think it's worth the price. I feel like there are so many good drugstore options. I think it does work really well if you are interested in spending money. I think it is good. One thing I'm not gonna buy anymore this year or ever again are eye creams or anything like that. I bought this Glow Recipe, the avocado sleeping mask. It didn't do anything. Like, I used pretty much the whole jar. Like, I scraped it out as much as I could. I bought it because people were saying, like, it helped with dark circles and everything. But the more research I did, dark circles, basically, like, you can't really get rid of them with the sleeping mask. Like, it's pretty much genetic and how your body is and like all of that stuff. Oh, and this shit's expensive too. I have another one that I winded up buying like last year, so I'm just using that basically to just get rid of it. I personally just think it's a waste of money. I guess it worked for some people because there were so many good reviews, but I didn't think it was any serious change. I think it felt cooling and then that was it. Like, my eyes would still be puffy, they'd still have dark circles. Another thing I'm not gonna repurchase is this Laneige lip glowy balm. They just kept raising the prices on this, like acting like I didn't see it happening. It made your lips look really nice and like moisturized, but not for the price. Probably almost $20 now. So you can definitely tell by this was a sample by how small it is. This is just Anastasia brow gel. I used to use her clear brow gel like religiously when I was in high school because it was like super glue for your brows or your hair, like your baby hair. But again, I'm not gonna buy anything higher end brow product. This was okay. I do prefer the clear brow gel over like the tinted color. So one thing that I'm not gonna repurchase, this is kind of like Tool or e.l.f. brushes. They're very cheap, like price wise, and I feel like you basically get what you pay for. I do like how the brushes are, that's why I want to buy them, but they fall apart. And I mean, you could probably super glue it back together, but now it's all like crooked and bent side. Look at the brush, it's not even straight. If anyone else has this problem, it's happened before, or if it doesn't break off, it starts getting really loose. That's how my foundation brush is. I'm like not repurchasing anything. This is Thayer's Witch Hazel facial toner. This was like very popular on TikTok, and then everyone was saying not to buy it because it has alcohol in it, but it says alcohol free, so I don't understand why people were saying that. But anyways, I'm not gonna repurchase it. I don't really think it was anything special, and I feel like a lot of people were just saying not to buy this now because it's bad for your skin. I don't know if that's actually true, but it didn't do anything for me. Another thing that I'm not gonna repurchase is this Ordinary Niacinamide. Is that how you pronounce it? But it looks like this. Again, like, I didn't notice any difference in my skin. I know a lot of people love this brand. I just don't think that this high strength vitamin and mineral blemish formula, like, I still got blemishes. A lot of people like that though, so maybe it works for other people, like hair and body stuff. So Tresemme has been going through some shit lately. I don't know what's going on. There's all these claims now that it has some sort of ingredient, makes you lose your hair or something. I have no idea. I've used this since like middle school, this hairspray. Unless I start losing a lot of hair. I feel like it works really well though on curly hair. I always like to have like this French kind of look until further notice. This is Herbal Essences Hello Hydration. This is like a hair and body wash shampoo. I actually have another one, a new one. I like this. I feel like it makes your hair smell good, makes your hair feel soft. You know, all that good stuff. So definitely would recommend this. And I think it's kind of cool you can use it as a body wash too. I feel like a lot of shampoos are bad for like your body. That's why a lot of people get like pimples and stuff on their back. So I feel like it's good that the shampoo, you can use it on your body. So my last thing is this Olay body wash. I love this. I've used this for years because I don't like floral scented stuff or anything else like that, but I still want to have some sort of scent. And this just smells so good. The sea salt one, I could not find this in stores. I was going crazy because I'm like, oh my God, did they discontinue it? They changed the packaging and they didn't tell me is what happened. Here it is. I like this new packaging though. It looks sleek, it looks nice. Yeah, if you're looking for it, it's just in a new bottle. This is like the best body wash I think I've ever used. I also have sensitive skin. Skin is always very dry. I have eczema certain times of the year, so this doesn't irritate it at all. So definitely recommend it. So that is everything that I had to share for my product empties, and I'll see you guys next time. Thank you for watching.